here with us now, the Republican
you
senator.
Love for, saying that, don't
just,
you?
It makes no
you
sense.
You love saying that.
It makes no sense,
think,
Tom Brokaw.
You just think
well,
we're not
like Governor Romney saying you deport yourself.
Yeah, we're starting right. at stopping. Yeah. Here with us now is Senator Kay Bailey Hutchinson, who is retiring from the Senate this year. It is really great to have you back on the show this morning.
I'm so glad to be here and so glad you all are here and just having a hurricane party with all of you.
It's going to be fun. We've got a bar.
Yeah.
We're good.
I know.
There's a place
the
senator was telling me before we went on the air that she's become a regular viewer of Morning Joe.
Oh, I am.
We love it.
Why, thank you.
We love it. Now, you also were saying before we came on the air, you're talking about all the conventions that you've been to, and you were in Kansas City in 76 for a convention that really mattered, but you and Tom were telling the most fascinating story.
Oh, don't go there.
About the 1980 convention where... Yeah, a lot of people were huddled in a room to make a historic decision, okay?
Yes, talking about who would be Reagan's vice presidential nominee, and Ford was the big boomlet that he was talking to Ford about being the vice president when Ford was actually, you know, coming off the presidency.
There are heavy negotiations going on in a penthouse between the Reagan team and the Ford team. Are we losing light?
Yes, we are.
Losing light.
I'm sorry. It's
well,
a hurricane.
It's sort of, we're setting the mood.
Back
taking
down
us back
to
1980. So Tom Brokaw
right,
takes
Tom.
Us back to 1980.
Can I get you a drink?
I'm going to go outside.
Look at this. It's Ken Burns lighting where it's sort of shade.
Oh,
it's very
we're
dramatic.
I thought when they cut to me, giving my aging face, I thought they were softening the lamp.
Oh, exactly.
So
at any rate,
but
1980, they had not picked a vice presidential candidate yet. They get to the convention and they start these heavy negotiations. Someone that Andrea knows very well, Alan Greenspan, was in the room, who had been an economic advisor to President Ford. Henry Kissinger played a very large role in these negotiations. And President Ford was eager to be the vice presidential candidate with an entirely new portfolio of responsibilities, including a lot in national security and foreign policy. The delegates were left in suspense on the floor of the convention. We were all waiting for the announcement.
But you said that CBS got in front of it. It sounded like it was going to be Reagan, Ford, and then you had somebody come up to you saying, don't believe it.
What happened is that Jim Thompson, the governor of Illinois, had some buttons made up that said Reagan, Ford, and he was wearing them inside his jacket. And I went over and did an interview with him on the air like at 11 o'clock at night. And Bob Dole came down and said to me, what did he just tell you? I said, he just all but said to me that it's going to be Reagan Ford. And Senator Dole said, that's not going to happen. We got to shut this down. And he left the convention floor with Howard Baker, went over to the hotel, and whatever transpired. Somebody came running onto the convention floor, and as Chris Wallace is happy to tell you,
they shut it down, though, right?
They shut it down.
So Dole went over there with Baker. They shut it down.
They went over and said, we got to get this concluded in some fashion. Yeah. How much they had an impact in shutting it down, I don't know. I do know that the Reagan kitchen cabinet, so-called, Holmes, Tuttle, and William French Smith, they didn't like the idea of handing off presidential authority to the vice president. So
but Kissinger
somebody
loved
from
it.
Somebody from the hotel suite came running onto the convention floor, and as Chris Wallace will tell you, it's been going on for a long time, he was the guy who was told it's Bush. And he went on the air and said simply, it's Bush.
Wow.
And it electrified the convention floor. I was sitting with Bob Michael down in the front row. He was the, at that time, the minority leader of the House of Representatives. And a couple of other people said, you know, a dream died. Some people thought on the floor it was a good idea to do that.
Yeah. All right, let's get to the issue of women, Senator Hutchinson. We've got some polls that we can show you here. We talked about them at the top of the show, showing a little bit of a problem with the women. The women's vote for the Republican Party.
You say a little bit of a problem. I mean, 29, 30 points. I mean, come on.
It's a huge problem,
right,
Senator. It's a huge problem.
What's 30 points between friends?
How are they going to close the gap? And do you agree there's a problem? I mean, is there any way you can try and devalue this?
Well, the numbers are there, that's for sure. And frankly, Republicans have had a gender gap routinely. However, I think the way we're going to close it is we're going to talk about the middle class and moms and the concern about jobs and the economy. I mean, mothers are having their kids move back home. I've got friends whose kids are getting internships when they graduate from college because they cannot get real jobs.
By the way, unpaid,
and they're just glad.
Unpaid internships, right.
And just to have the experience, and they're happy to get it. So this is what moms are going to start looking at and saying, you know what, we can do better. four more years of huge debt, Obamacare, which is scaring the small business people in this country to death, and the overregulation and the big government coming back, I think we're going to talk economy. We're not going to talk touchy-feely who likes who the most. We're not electing the captain of the football team.
As Governor Romney said to Chris Wallace on Fox News yesterday, he said, the reason that we tried so vehemently, and that was his word, vehemently, to get Todd Akin out of the race is because we know that this is hurting women, damaging women, and hurting the party. So he's acknowledging that there is a problem here on the issues of reproduction because of the comments about rape that Todd Akin issued. And also, the platform is controversial. The platform has no exceptions in it. It doesn't specify, but it...
Well, it doesn't specify.
But it's broad enough.
And it's been that way since 1980.
It's been that way forever, but it is reinforcing because of Akin.
Well,
it's
reinforcing a message. Party platforms, not anybody can look at either the Democratic or the Republican platform and say verbatim that that is mainstream America. In the mainstream of a platform, you've got the ideals, but I just don't think that is at all what we ought to be talking about. We ought to be talking about the issues of this country, and this country's in a financial crisis like we have never seen before.
Senator Haley Barbour said he was glad to be out of the big bad business of politics. It just shocks and stuns him. Are you looking forward to retiring from the Senate?
Oh, yes. yes.
It's not the place that it was when you got in there.
No, it's not.
That's sad.
Mostly it's because, you know, I do believe in term limits. I think you need to cycle in and have the experience and then cycle back out and go in the real world
and
control your schedule.
Thank you very much for being here. Senator Kay Bailey Hutchison, thank you so much. Great to see you. Still ahead, Chris Matthews joins the conversation here in Tampa.